Good morning, all of you. So welcome back to new session. So up to now, in last sessions, we discussed about in the case of first unit, we discussed about chemical bonding and water technology. In the case second unit, we discussed about electrochemistry. After that, in unit three, we discussed about batteries, how to construct some of the batteries and applications of various batteries and all those things. So now we are actually going to the fourth unit. So this is basically. In this case, we are going to discuss about some of the important instrumental techniques for the chemical analysis. So whenever this electromagnetic radiation sending toward the unknown matter or matter, so then what will happen? Basically, there are three different processes will be there. If an unknown compound not absorbing any light, all the light actually coming like this. So then that is actually called transmission. So actually light enters into the medium, that means matter, and the same energy actually coming outside. So there is an absorption of light. So whatever the intensity we are sending, for example, I am sending actually 100% intensity light. So 100% intensity light toward this unknown compound, but it is not absorbing any radiation. At the same time, it can actually the radiation actually going inside and coming out with the same amount, same intensity only. That means there is no absorption of light. So that is actually a transmission. So radiation can go through the material and coming outside without any absorption. So that is actually a transmission process in this manner. Or here you can see, so in this case, this particular compound, this particular matter, whenever we are sending electromagnetic radiation toward the compound, it is not absorbing and it is also not transmitted. So there is a reflection process. So just it changing the direction and actually going in other direction in this manner. So this is the incident direction and this is actually reflected direction. So like this, there is a reflection process also will be there depending on the either unknown compound or unknown matter. But in some cases, what will happen? Here you can see, so what are the radiation we are sending toward the unknown compound or matter? So that is completely absorbed. There is no transmittance and there is no reflection process. So like this, generally whenever electromagnetic radiation interacts with matter, so these are the possible changes. Either there is a transmission process or there is an absorption process or there is a reflection process. So this transmitted radiation also actually providing some information about this particular matter, or this absorbed radiation also actually giving lot of information about this particular matter, or even this reflected radiation also actually providing some information about this particular matter. So like this, whenever electromagnetic radiation interacts with matter, there are three possible changes: either transmission or absorption or reflection process like this. Okay, so now let us see what is happening whenever we are sending different types of radiation toward the unknown matter. So for example, here, so this picture actually indicates the possible molecular changes whenever different types of electromagnetic radiations interacts with matter. So let us say this is one of the unknown compound. So now we are actually sending microwave radiation toward the unknown compound. So what is the meaning of microwave radiation? So microwave radiation means that is one of the lower energy radiation, longer wavelength actually there. So longer wavelength means lower energy. Whenever microwave radiation sending toward the molecule, it cannot do any excitation kind of things. So just it can able to change some rotations. So this molecule can actually rotate in this manner like this. The rotation energy of the corresponding molecule actually changes when compared to the normal state. So there is a rotational changes actually there. So that actually provides, we can observe lot always molecule rotations in the case of corresponding molecule. So whenever if you are providing microwave radiation toward the unknown compound, always there is a rotational changes only. Some of the bonds actually rotating in this manner. So that we will see in the next slide. Instead of microwave radiation, if you are providing infrared radiation. So what is the infrared radiation? Infrared radiation actually little bit higher energy radiation when compared to the microwave radiation. You can see here. So this is the energy level, but this is the energy of this one. So infrared radiation actually little bit higher energy, higher in energy. If you are providing infrared radiation toward the unknown molecule, due to the higher energy, so in this case we can observe some of the bond vibrations. So this molecule actually vibrating like in this direction or in this direction or in this direction. So bonds actually migrating something like this. So we will observe some kind of molecular vibrations in a given molecule. So vibration energy of the corresponding molecule actually changes whenever if you are providing infrared radiation towards the unknown molecule. And instead of infrared radiation, if you are providing either visible or ultraviolet radiation, either visible radiation or ultraviolet radiation. So let us assume this is one of the molecule and these are the different energy levels. We know that according to molecular dipole theory, whenever there is a molecule formation, we have some kind of bonding levels and we have some antibonding molecular levels. And all the bonding electrons actually available either here, if there is any more electrons, those are actually enters into the antibonding level. So that means in the case of molecule, we have some of the energy states like this, bonding lower energy states and higher energy states. Here also where I am trying to represent, this is the same picture only. This is actually one of the molecule. Let us assume this is one of the molecule. So this solid line or solid circle actually indicates that is actually bonding level. And the corresponding dotted lines or circles are actually indicates that actually those are actually antibonding levels or non-bonding levels. Non-bonding levels like this. So initially in the case of molecule, most of the electrons are actually trying to occupy the only bonding molecular orbitals. If more number of electrons are available, those are actually either enters into the non-bonding level or in the case of antibonding level. So that means in the case of molecule, we have some number of energy levels, electronic energy levels like this, because all these levels actually occupied by electrons only. Bonding molecular orbitals consists number of electrons like this. So these are actually electronic energy levels. So let us assume that this molecule actually having two number of electrons in one of the lowest energy level like this. If you are providing higher energy radiation like visible or UV radiation towards this molecule, so what will happen? Some of these electrons actually excited like this. Some of these electrons actually enters from lower energy level to the next higher energy level in this manner. So like this, electron level changes whenever ultraviolet radiation or visible radiation sending towards the unknown molecule. In the case of molecule, what are the lower energy electrons are available? So those electrons are actually moving to the next higher energy levels, either non-bonding level or antibonding level. So like this, electronic changes also possible whenever this ultraviolet radiation, visible radiation sending towards the unknown molecule. And after that, instead of that, if you are providing X-rays like this. So X-rays means these are a higher energy radiation when compared to the all other radiations like a micro radiation or infrared radiation or visible or ultraviolet radiation. These are actually higher energy radiations. So these radiation, whenever this radiation enters into the unknown matter, so there is a excitation of some of the electrons. So some of the electrons completely leaving that level and going to the higher levels. There is excitation process or ionization process. So that ionization process actually providing a different type of information of the corresponding unknown molecule. So like this, depending on the source of radiation, source of electromagnetic radiation, we can observe different types of molecular changes in the corresponding unknown molecule. So micro radiation can able to change the molecular rotations. Infrared radiation can able to change the molecular vibrations. Ultraviolet, visible light actually change the, in that case there is a electronic excitations. If there is a X-rays, there is a complete ionization of the corresponding molecule into corresponding charged particles. So like this, different radiations interacts with unknown molecules in a different manner and provides different types of information based on the corresponding molecule and bond connectivity, all those things. So but in our syllabus we have these two techniques only, infrared, visible and ultraviolet radiation techniques only. So let me show you what is the meaning of rotational changes. So whenever, as I said in the previous slide, if you are providing microwave radiation toward the unknown molecule, so for example, so I am sending this microwave radiation toward the unknown molecule like this. So you can see this molecule actually rotating. So this is the axis. So this is actually rotating in this manner. And here also this is the bonding axis. So this is the axis. So in this case, there is CC bond actually available in this manner, and this is actually rotating in this manner. So this carbon atom actually rotating in this manner. And in fourth case also, so this is the bonding axis. Along this axis, there is a rotation process. Like this, whenever this micro radiation enters into the corresponding unknown molecule, in the given molecule, in the given compound, there are some kind of rotational changes. Molecules actually undergoes rotations along the bonding axis, one of the bond axis like this, either this one or any other like this. And this is the range of the micro radiation you can see here. So 3 into 10 power 10 to 3 into 10 power 12 hertz in frequency units, or in case of wavelength units, this is actually 1 centimeter to 100 micrometer like this. Okay. And so whenever this micro radiation enters into the molecule, we will observe some kind of molecular changes, marked rotations like this, and that rotations actually provides actual rotation spectrum in this manner. The rotational changes actually observed spectrum like this. So from this spectrum, we can able to understand the bond nature of the corresponding molecule. For example, whether this is a CC single bond or double bond, or this is whether this is a polar bond or non-polar bond. Like this, we can able to get some information about the corresponding bonds actually. Available different types of bonds available in the corresponding molecules. So in case if you are providing micro radiation towards the unknown molecule, there is a rotation spectroscopy. So the rotation spectroscopy actually providing corresponding rotation spectrum in this manner, and we have to analyze this spectrum, and we will get some information about the corresponding molecule actually. So this is one. But instead of microwaves, if you are providing infrared radiation, so infrared radiation actually little bit higher range radiation when compared to micro radiation. You can see here the range actually 3 into 10 power 12 to 3 into 10 power 14 hertz, or in terms of wavelength 100 micrometer to 1 micrometer. So wavelength gradually decreasing. Yes or no? So wavelength decreases means energy increases. That means this is actually one of the higher range radiation. Whenever this infrared radiation interacts with the unknown compound like this, so in this molecule you can see some of the vibrational changes. So these are not the rotations. In the previous slide we have seen the rotations actually, but here there is a rotations. You can see clearly some of the bonds actually vibrating. Yes or not? You can see here. So all these groups actually vibrating, or you can observe here also. These one kind of vibrations. Bond actually bond length increasing and decreasing. So like this, whenever this infrared radiation interacts with the corresponding molecule, we can observe some of the vibrational changes in a given molecule in this manner. So from these vibrational changes, we can able to get the a lot of information about the various functional groups available in a given molecule. So in this particular compound, what type of functional groups are available, whether this molecule contains C double bond or functional group, or OH group, or NH group, or C double bond S group like this, or C triple bond N kind of group, or aromatic group like this. So it will give lot of information of the various functional groups available in a given unknown molecule from the vibration spectroscopy. So that means if you are using infrared radiation, there is a vibrational changes in the corresponding molecule. There is a vibrational changes. So that vibrational changes actually providing vibration spectroscopy or infrared spectroscopy. So that spectroscopy actually we will get, in this case we will get actually vibration spectrum or IR spectrum, infrared spectrum. So this information, this infrared spectrum actually providing different types of functional groups available in a given unknown molecule. So that is actually possible from the IR spectroscopy or vibration spectroscopy. And similarly, if you are providing visible or ultraviolet radiation, so let us say this is your molecule. So this is your molecule. So initially electron available in the lower energy state only. You can clearly observe here, initial electron actually available in lower energy state. But whenever this radiation enters into the molecule. So whenever this radiation actually enters into the molecule, so you can see, so this electron actually going to the higher energy level in this manner. Again, that is going back to the lower energy state. So that actually produces emission spectrum, and because of absorption, we will get actually absorption spectrum like this. So in this case, there are two types of spectrums actually possible: emission type of spectrum as well as absorption types of spectrum. And this is the range of the visible and UV radiation, 3×10^14 to 3×10^16 Hz, or wave number, wavelength decreases from 1 micrometer to 10 nanometers. 10 nanometers further decreasing. So wavelength decreases, energy increases. So like this, in this case, there is a kind of electronic transitions. Electrons available in the lowest level are actually enters into the higher levels, like bonding levels to the antibonding level or bonding level to the non-bonding level. So there is a electronic excitations. In this case, electronic excitations are there, or electronic transitions are there. So that leads to produce actually electronic spectrum like this, that actually produces corresponding electronic spectrum or UV absorption spectrum or emission spectrum in this manner. So from these spectrum details, from this spectrum, we can able to get the some information about the corresponding molecule, like what type of unsaturation is there, whether this molecule contains any kind of conjugated double bonds. Conjugated double bond means alternative double bonds, like this. This is actually conjugation. The given molecule contains any C triple bond C kind of groups, that means alkene kind of groups or alkene kind of groups. So basically it actually provides some information about the unsaturation available in the given compound. So like this, UV visible spectroscopy also actually providing lot of information about the unknown compound in this manner. So like these different electromagnetic radiations actually interacts with corresponding molecule and provides different types of information about the corresponding unknown molecule. Okay, so this is like this. So if we are providing micro radiation, there is a molecular rotations. So we can see changes in molecular rotations. If you are providing infrared radiation, we will observe corresponding vibrational changes. If you are providing UV and ultraviolet radiation, there is electronic excitations. If you are providing X-rays, we can observe some kind of ionization process. So this is all about the interaction of electromagnetic radiation with matter. So, but among these techniques, in our syllabus, we have UV visible as well as IR techniques. We want to focus only on the these two techniques only. So, and another thing actually, so as I said, if you are providing microwave, so there is some kind of rotation changes in this manner. You can see here, rotation energy increases in this manner. So that means each molecule always contains some kind of rotation energy levels like this. Each molecule always having some number of rotation energy levels like this. And if you are providing infrared radiation, some of the initially maybe this molecule actually having little amount of rotation energy, but once you provide micro radiation, the rotation energy actually further increases. That means initially molecule actually available in this state, then it actually goes to the next level like this because of the absorption of radiation like this. Similarly, each molecule also contains some number of vibration energy levels. Each molecule also contains some number of vibration energy levels like this. Let us say this is the V1, lowest energy level. This is actually the second level, third level like this. If you are providing infrared radiation, we will observe some kind of vibration changes in the corresponding molecule. So therefore, initially molecules actually available with the lowest vibration energy. Whenever if you provide infrared radiation, so those molecules actually extend to the next level like this. So we will observe some kind of vibration energies changes like this. So initially molecules available in V1 state, but after absorption of infrared radiation, those are actually goes to the V2 state like this. This is the V2 state. So V2 state or V3 state like this. Okay. Similarly, each molecule also having electronic levels, different types of electronic levels, different types of electronic levels like this. So initially molecules actually available in the lower energy states. Lower energy states nothing but actually sigma bonding or pi bonding only. So these are actually called lower energy states, either sigma bonding or pi bonding. After that, we have a non-bonding level. After that, pi star. After that, sigma star only. So these are the possible energy levels. So sometimes these pi electrons goes to the pi star level or sigma star level. Some other cases, the sigma star goes to the pi star and sigma star level like this. Like this, we have a different types of electronic transitions. That's the reason here I mentioned actually sigma to sigma star transition. Sigma to sigma star actually possible. A pi to pi star transition. Pi to pi star actually possible. N to pi star. N means non-bonding level. N to pi star, N to sigma star actually possible. Or N to pi star actually possible. And sigma to pi star or sigma and pi to sigma star. So like this, in the case of electronic spectra, six possible transitions actually possible in this manner. So like this, in each case we have different types of transitions. Either rotational changes, that means we have a rotation spectra based on the rotation transition like this, R1 to R2. Or we have a vibration spectra, in that case we have a vibration changes. So molecules available in the V1 level actually going to the V2 level. Or electronic transitions. Electrons initially available in the bonding orbitals, either sigma or pi. Those are actually enters into the non-bonding or anti-bonding level. So that actually called electronic transitions. So this is all about the different types of transitions available in a given molecule. And lastly, we have two different types of spectroscopy techniques. Either absorption spectroscopy or emission spectroscopy. So what is the meaning of absorption spectroscopy means? Here you can understand. So let us assume that this is one of the ground state level. So ground state level means either vibration level or rotation level or electronic level. So initially molecules or electrons are in the lower energy state only. Whenever if you provide some kind of electromagnetic radiation, so this molecule or this atom actually goes to the next higher energy level like this. So that means during this process, there is absorption of radiation. We have to provide some radiation. Here, we are actually providing this much amount of radiation. So whenever if we provide some amount of radiation like this, this molecule actually absorbing that radiation and going to the higher energy levels. So because of this absorbed radiation, if you are getting some information about the unknown molecule, that is actually absorption spectra, absorption technique. At the same time, once molecule enters into the excited state like this, again it is actually coming back to the ground state like this. Again that is coming back to the ground state like this, but at that time it is actually releasing the same amount of energy. Here the same amount of energy actually released. Again that is actually coming outside. So because of this radiation, this is actually called emitted radiation. The excited molecule or the excited atom actually emitting some radiation. So from this radiation, if you are getting some information about the unknown molecule, so that is actually called emission spectroscopy. So like this, we have two different types of techniques, absorption spectroscopy or emission spectroscopy. So absorption spectroscopy means the ground state molecules actually absorbing radiation and going to the excited state like this. And if you are depending on the how much amount of radiation absorbed by that particular particular compound, that is actually called absorption studies. If you are depending on the how much amount of radiation emitted by the excited molecule, that is actually called emission studies. But what are the techniques we are going to learn? Like UV spectroscopy, infrared spectroscopy, both are actually absorption types of techniques only. So most of the cases we are depending on the how much amount of energy absorbed by the molecule only. So in some particular cases we are also depending on the how much amount of energy released by the molecule also. So that is actually a different concept. But what are the techniques we are going to learn here? Both are actually absorption techniques only. So we will see all these details in the next class onwards. In the next class, I'm going to start actually UV visual spectroscopy. What is the main principle of the UV spectroscopy? All those things. Okay. So this is all of the today's session. So again, we will meet in the next session. So if you have any doubts, please contact to my email ID or mobile number. So thank you one and all.